Hey, yeah, students, now I'm going to tell you what is Avagadro's law, Avagadro's hypothesis. It tells us that at similar condition of temperature, pressure, and all physical condition, equal volume of all gases occupy equal number of molecules. Okay, it's one and the same thing, or you can say equal number of molecules of all gases occupies equal volume. Okay, I have one container over here and its capacity is say 100 ml. I put nitrogen in it. I am putting nitrogen inside it, nitrogen, and I measure the number of molecules, suppose the number of molecules come out to be 1 lakh. Just an assumption, come out to be 1 lakh. Now I replace nitrogen and the container is same. It is the same container. It is 100% same container. And I put hydrogen inside it. I put hydrogen. Now what are the number of molecules of hydrogen? If the conditions are same, means if in both the case, the temperature, the pressure and all other physical conditions remains same, then the number of molecules of hydrogen will also be 1 lakh. Under similar condition of temperature and pressure and all other physical condition, equal volume of all gases, the volume is equal, this is also 100 ml, this is also 100 ml, contains equal number of molecules. Okay, so this was so simple, no? Yes, I'll explain you through another method. Suppose under similar conditions, 60 ml of hydrogen contains X molecules. Then 60 ml of another gas, carbon dioxide, will contain, yes, equal volume, contains equal molecule, X molecules. And 60 ml of sulfur dioxide, it will also contain X molecules. So under similar conditions, all the gases which have equal volume contains equal number of molecules. What I mean is that the volume of gas is proportional to number of molecules, provided all other conditions such as temperature and pressure remains constant. If these two things are constant, then volume of gas is proportional to number of molecules. Let us extend this question. What if I have 30 ml of carbon monoxide? Now this is not equal. This is half. So volume is proportional to number of molecules. Molecules will also become half. Will contain X by 2 molecules. Of what? Of carbon monoxide. What if I have 120 ml of nitrogen? Now this is not the same volume. The volume has been doubled. So number of molecules also doubled. 2x molecules of nitrogen. Do you notice these two cases? Are you getting this? If volume is half and gas is changed, molecule also halves, provided temperature and pressure remains constant. So if equal volume, then equal number of molecules. If half the volume, then half the molecules. And if double the volume, then double the molecules. Now let us take one last question which will clear all your doubts about this topic. And the question is, under same temperature and pressure, this column is given to you, this table is given to you, okay? The table is 50 liter hydrogen and 100 liter carbon dioxide and 200 liter methane, and what we have 75 liter nitrogen, and it is given 50 liter of hydrogen contains Y molecules. Now you calculate number of molecules in these gases. If we have 50 liter CO2, it will contain same number of molecules, that is Y, but we have 100, that is double. So volume is doubled, molecule is also doubled. So we have 2Y molecules of CO2. Now this is 200 liter. Now the volume is increased 4 times. 54s are 200. So molecule will also become 4 times 4Y molecules of methane, that is CH4. And the last one, we have 75 liter nitrogen. Now what to do? Now you apply unitary method. 50 liters contain Y molecule, 1 liter contains Y by 50 molecule, 75 liter will contain Y by 50 into 75. So this will become Y, 25, 3 the 75, 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 Y molecules of what? Of nitrogen. This was all from Avogadro's hypothesis. Thank you.